Welcome to this tutorial on setting up a development environment for learning JavaScript. We will cover everything you need to get started with JavaScript development, from setting up a text editor and installing Node.js to creating a development server and working with a browser. We will also cover some useful browser extensions for JavaScript development. By the end of this tutorial, you will have a complete development environment set up and ready to start learning and building amazing things with JavaScript. Choosing a text editor or IDE. The first step in setting up a development environment is choosing a text editor or integrated development environment IDE. A text editor is a lightweight tool that lets you write and edit text files, while an IDE is a more powerful tool that offers features such as code highlighting, auto-completion, and debugging. There are many options available for JavaScript development, but in this tutorial, we will be using VS Code, a popular and free code editor developed by Microsoft. To download VS Code, simply visit code.visualstudio.com and click the download button for your operating system. Once the download is complete, follow the instructions to install the software on your computer. The next step in setting up your development environment is installing Node.js, a JavaScript runtime built on the Chrome V8 engine. Node.js allows you to run JavaScript code outside of a browser, making it an essential tool for building web applications and APIs. To download Node.js, visit nodejs.org and click the download button for your operating system. Once the download is complete, follow the instructions to install the software on your computer. After installing Node.js, you can check that it is correctly installed by opening your terminal or command prompt and typing node-v. This will display the version of Node.js you have installed on your computer. The third step in setting up your development environment is installing a package manager. A package manager is a tool that helps you manage and install third-party libraries and frameworks for your JavaScript projects. There are several package managers available for JavaScript development, but in this tutorial, we will be using NPM, Node Package Manager, which is included with Node.js. To use NPM, open your terminal or command prompt and type npm-v. This will display the version of NPM you have installed on your computer. You can use NPM to install JavaScript libraries and frameworks by typing npm install package name in your terminal. For example, to install the popular jQuery library, you can type npm install jQuery. Setting up your development server. Now that we have a text editor, Node.js, and npm installed, we can move on to setting up a development server. A development server is a local server that you can use to run your JavaScript applications and test them in a browser. In this tutorial, we will be using Node.js and the Express.js framework to set up our development server. Express.js is a popular Node.js framework that provides a simple way to create web applications and APIs. To get started, create a new folder for your project and open it in your text editor. Then open your terminal or command prompt and navigate to the project folder. Once you are in the project folder, type npm init to create a new npm package for your project. Follow the prompts to set up the package. Next, install the Express.js framework by typing npm install express in your terminal. This will download and install the framework and its dependencies. Once the installation is complete, create a new file in your project folder called index.js. This will be the main file for our server. In this file, we will import the Express.js framework, create a new instance of the app, and define a route to serve a basic HTML page. Thank you. To run the server, type node index.js in your terminal. This will start the server and you should see a message indicating that the server is listening on a certain port, usually 3000 by default. Open your browser and navigate to the localhost server to see your server in action. Now that we have our development server up and running, we can start working with a browser to test our JavaScript applications. There are many modern web browsers available, but for this tutorial, we will be using Google Chrome. Chrome has a built-in set of developer tools that you can use to inspect HTML, CSS, and JavaScript on a web page. To access these tools, simply right-click on a web page and select Inspect from the context menu. Once you have the developer tools open, you can use them to inspect elements on the page, view the console output, and debug your JavaScript code. These tools are essential for any web developers, so make sure you take the time to familiarize yourself with them. Finally, let's talk about browser extensions. Browser extensions are small software programs that you can install in your browser to add extra functionality or features. There are many browser extensions available for JavaScript development, and in this tutorial, we will be installing three useful extensions: Live Reload, Vue.js DevTools, and React Developer Tools. Live Reload is a browser extension that automatically refreshes your browser whenever you make changes to your code. This is useful for seeing your changes in real time without having to manually refresh the page. Vue.js DevTool is a browser extension that provides advanced debugging and inspection tools for Vue.js applications. If you are planning to learn Vue.js, this extension is a must-have. React Developer Tools is a browser extension that provides similar debugging and inspection tools for React.js applications. If you are planning to learn React.js, this extension is also a must-have. To install these extensions, simply search for them in a Chrome Web Store and click Add to Chrome. Once installed, you should see their icons in your browser's toolbar. And that's it for this tutorial on setting up a development environment for learning JavaScript. We covered everything from setting up a text editor and installing Node.js to creating a development server and working with a browser. We also talked about some useful browser extensions for JavaScript development. With this knowledge, you now have a solid foundation for learning and building amazing things with JavaScript. So go ahead, get started, and have fun.